My wife had her final dress fitting. You finished with all your dress fittings and all that shit? See? I didn't even know women had dress fittings. I was stunned to learn. I had no idea. Like, guys don't have dress fitting. I guess we could, a guy, you know, calling their shit over the phone, show up to the church, there's a tuxedo hanging on a filing cabinet. If it fits, it's great. If it doesn't, well, you're still walking down there, so it really doesn't matter a whole lot. I don't have dress fittings. She came in, almost laid on bed, almost in tears. I'm like, what's going on? She said, well, my dress doesn't fit. I said, what happened? She said, I guess I put on like 3 pounds. You know, when I gain any kind of weight, it goes all to my chest. She said, I can't fit in my dress. My boobs are too big. They're busting out. I don't know what to do. I said, relax, calm down, let's go have some chocolate cake and figure this out. Tried to help my wife plan for our wedding. Learned a lot of weird things about myself that I didn't know. I learned that I was colorblind. Because I didn't know the difference between cornflower and periwinkle. She's pissed. You can't tell the difference between these two colors? Hey, I didn't know those were colors. Well, this one obviously has purple in it. No, you know what obviously has purple in it? Purple. That's what obviously. Won't let it go, has to justify it, has to be right. I said, well, you should know what cornflower is. That was a color we had in our crayon boxes when we were in school. Wasn't in my crayon box, Princess 64 crayons, flip top, fancy sharpener in the back. You hear them? You want me to tell you who those people are? Those are the other broke-ass kids like me that had the Crayola 8 beginner box. The great big jumbos, this kind. I almost flunked art in first grade because of those crayons. Teacher walked over to me, he's like, Chad, you know you really got out of the lines here coloring the sun. I know my yellow crayon weighs 9 pounds and I'm 6. I don't even have the physical strength or aptitude or dexterity to even do this. This is a great vocabulary for a 6-year-old. Kids would always ask to come to borrow my crayons. I think it was just to fuck with me, you know, because I had 8. Chad, do you have scarlet? No, I have red. Oh, do you have burnt sienna? Nope, that would be brown. Really, do you have tan? Yeah, it's brown. You just color really lightly. A lot more people get that joke than admitted to having the 8-pack of crayons, a bunch of liars. Once again, all the rich people out there is like, what's this 8-pack of crayon? I shan't have a clue again. Woman walks up to me after the show and she's like, you know, your 8-pack crayon, you know, the poor kid thing. She said, I understand exactly what you're talking about. And she had tears in her eyes because she had been laughing so hard. She said, I almost didn't come out because I had such a horrible week at work. She said, but you know, I decided to come out and you started talking about that and it reminded me of when I was younger and all these better times that I had. She said, because I know exactly what you're talking about because I had the crayon caddy. You know, the big thing was squared and swiveled. It had crayons all down one side, and you turned it, and it had markers. And you turned it again. It had, like, paints and paintbrush. You turned it again. It had, like, glue and glue sticks. The top was hollowed out. You could put, like, rulers and papers and everything in there. And she said, so I know what you mean. And she reached out to hug me, and I just wanted to punch her in the fucking face. Because that is not even close to what I was talking about. Not even near it.